the proportion z-test. For example, in 1999, it was reported that 30% of New Zealand high school students smoked. To encourage students to stop smoking, a high school principal implemented a campaign in hopes to decrease the percentage of students who smoke. 4 years later, he sampled 300 students and determined that 76 of them smoked. At the 5% level of significance, was there sufficient evidence to show the Stop Smoking campaign reduced the proportion of New Zealand high school students who smoked? For this example, we are going to perform a test of hypothesis at the 5% level of significance. Recall, there are 5 steps to testing a hypothesis. Step 1 is stating the hypotheses. In 1999, it was reported that 30% of New Zealand high school students smoked. So using notation, we have H naught is equal to P equaling 0.30. Remember to use the equal sign when writing the null hypothesis. Also, ensure that P is used because we are analyzing a proportion, and always convert the percent to a decimal. The principal wanted to show if the campaign was effective at reducing the proportion of New Zealand high school students who smoked. So using notation, we have our alternative hypothesis written as P being less than 0.30. Please note that less than is used because the principal wanted to show the proportion of New Zealand high school students who smoked was reduced. For step 2, we're going to identify the level of significance. The test of hypothesis was performed at the 5% level of significance. Thus, alpha is equal to 0.05. For step 3, we're going to compute the test statistic. Using the values from the scenario, make note of the values that represent the sample proportion and population proportion. Be careful not to confuse the two values. The sample proportion is derived from sample data. So in the sample of 300 students, 76 of them smoked. So for step 3, we're first going to identify p hat, which is equal to x over n. X was 76, and n was 300. And thus our sample proportion is equal to 0.2533. Now we can enter this information into the formula. And so we have z is equal to p hat minus p over the square root of p times q over n. So p hat is 0.2533 p, which comes from our null hypothesis, is 0.30. Recall that q is equal to 1 minus p, and so 1 minus 0.30 will be equal to 0.70. And our sample size was 300. Once we perform the math, we get a z equaling negative 1.76. For step 4, we're going to determine the critical values. Using this approach, alpha is equal to 0.05, and the symbol used for the alternative hypothesis is less than. Therefore, we have a one-tailed test with 0.05 in the left tail. So when we draw this out, you can see that we have a one-tailed test, also known as a left-tailed test. The rejection region is the area to the left, and that area is equal to 0.05, which is alpha. So the critical value that corresponds to this cutoff point is equal to negative 1.645. Our next step is to determine whether or not we can reject the null hypothesis. So our test statistic of negative 1.76 actually does fall into the rejection region, and therefore we are able to reject the null hypothesis. Now that we have rejected the null hypothesis, we can state our conclusion, which is step number 5. Therefore, we state that there is sufficient evidence to suggest that the proportion of New Zealand high school students who smoke is less than 30%.